All right, so positive gratitude forms, together at last. We have a beta plugin right now, which lets you map your field values over from a gratitude form submission into a pod container of any type. So that could be a user, comment, post type, taxonomy, advanced content type, whatever you may have created. And so this is actually code that has been evolved at least 3 or 4 times in major evolutions since about 2010 or 11. It started out as just some code and then some functions, and then just grew and grew. And finally, we added a UI recently through the help of Naomi Campbell. Naomi Bush.
She's that talented.
She's just helped us do some of the UI stuff while we were focusing on some other parts of Pods. And she put some code up recently on GitHub right now, so that's available to download. We'll have links up on the screens on our site whenever we do this video, but you can get to it at github.com/pods-gravity-forms, it's ready to go. You can use it right now. There are a couple limitations right now. The file uploader does not catch files, so it'll just go up to the ether. And we have not exposed 75-80% of what Pods Gratitude Forms plugin, this add-on actually does in the UI. So there's a lot more code stuff I'm going to show you here, but it does a lot more than just mapping data. So let's see here. So I have a site set up with Pods and Gratitude Forms, and it's just as simple as going to your forms, create a new form. Add a field. Maybe a field. Choose whatever field you want.
So are you in Gratitude Forms right now?
I'm in Gratitude Forms right now. This is not our stuff yet. So I just created a form. You can get to this pod screen through settings here or right here in the settings within the editor. So see form settings, confirmations, notifications, and then a pods link. And this will let you create new pods feeds. This lets you do conditional, so you can say if it's value of this equals something, then you can actually map it to a different pod depending on what you need. So let's go ahead and add a new one. Let's go ahead and select the articles pod. Let's just call this one article feed. And here I can map my field right over to right over into the article pod. Do my content, bing, bang, boom. There's lots of other options here. These are all built-in fields within WordPress, but it also has fields that you may have added. I didn't add any fields at the time to the article pod, but you can add as many custom fields as you need. And then you just hit update settings. And there you go. So now when it's done for that form, it'll go directly into the articles pods. You'll see that in the post list for the articles post type. You have a question?
I have. Does it do it for going forward, or can you take submitted information from Gravity Form?
We do not have an option right now for it to grab existing entries. That's a good idea. It would be pretty useful, I think. Certain situations, certainly.
So, relationships?
Yes, it does handle relationships. It goes by the text, so when you do your relationships field inside of the field editor for the form, and you have a drop-down, you have the option here to do show values. And the recommendation is, if you were going to have a relationship field, you should probably have your values and labels at least have the value mapped to what the actual text is inside of your related item. So if you have colors here, you just want to make sure you have that named as colors. Black, green, yellow. And then this text could be whatever. So like black shirt, green shirt, yellow shirt. And on save, Pods will go and find anything with a slug of black, green, or yellow, and it'll map it over and save it as a related item to this entry that's being submitted.
Okay, so I have to manually create my
my value list here?
Sort of. I believe we may have an option. We haven't exposed this yet, but there is the ability to auto-dynamically populate your drop-downs, your checkbox lists, your related item information into those fields. It's just a PHP call away. Yeah, so it's like a static function you call, and it's maybe one line. You tell it what form field, you tell it the form ID, and you say what related item you want to populate from. So it's pretty simple, but we've been working on this for our own purposes. We haven't had enough time to document it, but that's certainly on the list of things to do and things to expose in the UI. So there's a lot of stuff. So, all right. So in the code base, we have some really useful classes that we built. This is add-on code for the UI, but there's these two classes here that are very powerful. I built them in order to sustain a system which would have a list of items, page edit. You can have edit, add, and actually multiple actions other than just add and edit. So for a fraternity site I did, we had a reporting system which had a multiple page form which was extremely long, maybe too long, but they had come from a paper form and they converted it into this digital gravity form. And on submission, it goes out and sends it to the pod of its choice, and there's a lot of stuff. All of the code and all of this stuff is not actually using this add-on UI. It's actually using all the code base because I wanted to version it. But the actual code inside of it, so to call it, you call the function pods underscore gf underscore ui, and it maps this class and does all this stuff. But let's see if you can see that. Yeah. So you can basically pass a big array of your actions and your configuration. And you can see here that you can actually do quite a lot. You can provide custom action names, labeling, heading, header, define what fields to show in that action, to handle. Override values for field values during the save, save to a different ID. You can also save what happens when you're done saving. Let's see, callback. This is some more powerful things. This is dynamic select. So this is where it comes into hand, comes into the auto population of the fields. In this case, I'm actually providing a custom array, but I can choose a actual pod field and pod name, and I can say, hey, populate that. There's also pre-population, so you can actually pre-populate it with values. Redirect after, save for later is a unique feature that was added in this, but I think it's actually in grad forms now, or it's in the next version. But basically what happens is you're submitting a form and you're like, well, I need to come back to it later, but I don't want to lose all my information I put in. Save for later button, and then it just saves it into the database. Remember is actually, maybe it might be unique to this plugin, it lets you create a form so whenever you submit certain fields, you can actually specify which fields here, it'll remember the values of those fields every time you come back to the form. So someone who submits an expense report will always have their information filled in, but it may not be stored as their user information, it may just be whatever they had entered. So that's a useful case for that sort of feature. Yeah.
Getting back to the question on getting earlier forms data, couldn't you just do a CSV export import?
Yeah, you could. We don't have like a UI for our import for bots, but we do have a couple of line functions that you can just choose to say what path your CSV is in, and then it'll go through and import that. I think we're also, we have a command in WPC CLI now that will let you do the import as well. As long as it's the file is on the server, and the REST API has also got additional things. So you could do it through a number of different avenues. You could also do it manually with PHP. But it's not too hard to traverse through gravity form entries, so I don't see that being too hard to implement in the future. We also have a way to make inputs read-only. So like say you have a field inside of gravity forms like this site had, and it in a special action, it's called review. And so they didn't want the person who was reviewing it to be editing it, but they wanted to review it and say, this is good or this is bad, and then it goes back through a workflow. They have a whole entire workflow spider status list, and it's like, you submitted it, you've approved it, you've paid it, it's pending signatures, it goes through all these different steps, because as a fraternity, they have to manage a list of members for each chapter, a number of chapters for each province. There's a lot of moving parts, a lot of people who have to do certain things, and in their bylaws, they have to perform in a certain way. So that becomes a very useful feature. Auto-delete, of course, is really useful if you don't want to actually use Gratitude Forms for its entries. So you have it use it as purely as a skeleton for the forms, and have it sit all the way to pods and then forget about the entries. Markdown support, markdown for your HTML fields. So inside of your Gratitude Form form, you can have a field that's the HTML block, and you just put whatever HTML in there you want. For my client, they didn't want to do all that HTML stuff. They just wanted something really easy because they had a ton of content. So they just did a markdown, and that worked out really well for them. Editing lets you be able to edit a form entry. So in this case, we have support to submit data, but we also have support inside of this class to manipulate Gratitude Form entries as well. So you can actually use this for submitting data through Gratitude Forms into pods, or you can use this entirely within Gratitude Forms. So it's, I don't know if you've seen this other plugin that just got released, Gratitude Form Views. It's a way so you can list entries on a site in the table, and you can edit and all that stuff. But basically this does that, it's been doing that for a year or two now. And customize the submit button, customize the submit URL. Let's see here. Secondary submits is really useful, because in the workflow for this fraternity, they had multiple options. So they said approve it, do not approve it, cancel, return, stuff like that. So in this case, approve it was the main submit, and do not approve it submitted it with a different value for this this action. So it was really useful, because then we could just pick it up with some action hooks inside of WordPress and process it differently. There's also, let's see here, confirmation. You can also customize the confirmation via code as well, so you can specify certain things in the custom URLs based off the entry information, or through PHP you can customize that. So it's got a lot of really useful things, but by default it has a management table list and add, edit. We have a status change action that sort of lets you just switch the status real quick. A view, which is also unique to this one. You can view the content inside of, just basically it's a Gratitude Form, but it's instead of the inputs, it has the text, it has the values, so you can actually see the information and actually have access to edit it. And then delete, of course, you can delete entries and such. We have some other really complicated things. Let me see, how are we doing time?
You're at 15.
We have some other complicated things. I don't know how far this will go over some people's heads, but if you have workflow constraints where it says, in this case, for this fraternity, they only wanted people to submit one report every semester. So in the code, you're implementing a workflow constraint here so that they can add only one, and only if the status is not submitted or whatever. In their case, it was only if it's not processed. So they can only have one form in processing. And then notifications is actually, it's pretty useful. This lets you utilize, there's some other code in here that lets you register notification templates. And basically what it does is it lets you submit using different notifications than what is inside of Gratitude Forms, and do more dynamically supported things like if and else sort of conditions, depending on your uses. Let's see. And that's the main UI class, but there's so much more inside of the main PodsGF class here. And this is the meat and potatoes of the whole operation. It's a big class with lots of static calls that do all the different hooks within WordPress for Gratitude Forms, for validation, custom validation, filtering, read only handling, information, all that stuff. Let's see. Try to find some useful ones here. So, conditions is part of that workflow thing, but auto-delete, a lot of these things that you see here, like dynamic select, you could actually call these statically and not actually have to define anything inside of GraviForms UI. You don't have to provide any information about this form. You just call this pods underscore GF, colon, colon, dynamic underscore select, give it a form ID, give it a field ID, and it will automatically populate it from a pod field value. But if it's a relationship, it'll just fill it all in. So I built this in such a way that it can be used in two entirely separate ways, through a configuration array or through a static call, just really quick to add something as long as it's before the output of the form. Build choices, get selected choice. There's a lot of things I found inside of GraviForms that were hard to do, so I just filled this whole thing up with lots of utility functions that make it just easy to do certain things. But as you go through this list in the code, you'll find lots of other goodies. But we're hoping we can find some time after Pods 3.0 to get focused on documenting this specific add-on a lot more, because there's just so much raw power in it. I'm actually using it for thousands of users who are submitting reports and everything throughout every semester, and it's got a entirely completely custom role handling for their users, because some of them are members, some of them are chapter officers, some of them are chapter presidents, some are province officers, national staff, admins. So there's a lot of things going on that can't be just regular WordPress roles. So in that case, I built a whole plugin which is all file-based. All of the pages on the site are all file-based. Everything is pulling from this for its GraviForms interfaces, custom payments. There's lots of stuff that's built into it. So it's been put through the ringer, for sure. But I can't wait to show a lot more with real examples and documentation, because that's always the problem when you build code, is to make sure that you document it well enough so other people can use that and not have to ask you questions, or they may just totally give up on it. So at the very minimum, this plugin can at least map your fields with the UI, and that's still really useful. It's probably better than most of the other custom post type mapping plugins out there right now for GraviForms. So it's a pretty useful plugin. Does anyone have any questions before we go to the next reso? Talk too fast, sorry.
Well, multi-page form and form abandonment, and so, I mean, at what point do you save fields and pods?
It's only saved on submission. So if it's a multi-page form, it's not going to be saved until that final submit. It depends entirely on GraviForms. So if you have conditional pages shown to different cases, it'll only process when GraviForms says, I'm done. So, yeah, it was kind of tricky to get that way.
That remember function that you talked about, is that part of GraviForms?
No.
Oh, that's something you added.
Yep. Remember, save for later. A lot of these other things were all custom built for this application that I was doing. I wanted to just generalize it as much as possible so I could reuse it on multiple projects. All right. Well, that is that. The next prezo is planning before you build with Phil. Basically, make sure that you don't go out and cowboy build your site, because your data could change, your data needs could change. So he's got some cool stuff.
No one believes that.